Hello, today I will give you online introduction on another very important subject of medical laboratory technology, histopathology techniques, and I will consider all these points. 1. Introduction. 2. Definition of histology. 3. Definition of cytology. 4. Definition of histopathology. 5. Specimen collection. 6. Specimen processing. 7. Laboratory requirements. 9. Basic histopathology techniques. 10. Syllabus topics. And 11. MCQs with answers. During the study of histopathology techniques, you will learn to prepare stained slides of tissue and body fluids. These stained slides are then examined by qualified pathologists to diagnose whether the tissue or body fluid related stained slide is normal or related to any specific disease. One important thing you have to understand here is tissues are surgically collected by surgeons mainly in operation theater, and in the case of abdominal tissue or female reproductive system, laparoscopic technique is used to remove a specific tissue which needs histopathology examination. Fine needle aspiration is also a type of biopsy procedure. In fine needle aspiration, a thin needle is inserted into an area of abnormal appearing tissue or body fluid, and specimen is collected as a tissue sample for histopathological studies or as a body fluid for cytological examination. The various specimen used for exfoliative cytology are urine, sputum, vaginal and cervical smears, breast secretions, etc. By examining histopathological stained slides, pathologists are able to diagnose whether a person is suffering from a specific type of cancer. However, bacterial infections like tuberculosis or identification of specific parasite in the tissue is also possible by these techniques. In fact, by advanced immunohistochemistry techniques, it is also possible to diagnose specific antigen or specific antibody present in the histopathological specimen. Cytology means microscopic study of individual cell in a smear. Exfoliative cytology is concerned with the early detection of cancer. The malignant cells diffuse into the body fluids and secretions. The exfoliative cytological techniques deal with the study of body fluids and secretions by direct smear method and also by the study of concentrated material. Histology means study of tissue, and histology is a division of anatomy that deals with the minute structure, composition and functions of tissues. Histopathology means the study of disease tissues. Now let us consider briefly the histopathological studies. As I said earlier, the histopathological specimens are mostly collected by a surgeon in an operation theater, and the specimens in the form of small pieces of tissues are submitted to the histopathology section of a clinical laboratory. Each specimen is immediately placed in a proper fixative, and then it is entered in a logbook, which is called as logging, and after giving a specific identification number. A morphological description of the tissue is noted by the pathologist, and following gross examination and internal examination of the tissue, a portion of the tissue is trimmed and handed over to the histopathologist, a specialized technician in the laboratory, for laboratory processing. The pathologist responsible for the diagnosis of disease tissue is dependent on the technical skills of a technician who prepares microscopic slides of the specimen. These specimen slides should be very well sectioned and properly stained to provide detailed information of the tissue under examination. Now I will give you information on various types of requirements of a histopathology laboratory. First, glassware. General glassware required in histopathology laboratory include pipettes, flasks, beakers, and reagent bottles, which are also used in a biochemistry laboratory. The other special types of glassware and plasticware required include the following: 1. Specimen collecting containers, 2. Coupling staining jars or dishes, 3. Microscope slides and cover slips, 4. Containers for staining, 5. Staining jar, and 6. Various accessories for paraffin microtomy. Then the various chemicals and reagents. Following are the various reagents and chemicals used in histopathology laboratory. 1. Fixatives. 2. Various organic solvents. 3. Decalcifying solutions. 4. Embedding related chemicals and reagents. 5. Various staining solutions. 6. Various dilutions of ethyl alcohol. And 7. Mounting media, etc. Equipment used in histopathology laboratory is also specific. 1. Gross station, which is used for the gross examination of tissues. 2. Microtomes and cryostat for making very thin slices of the tissues. Then 3. Automatic tissue processor for the various tissue processing procedures. And 4. Paraffin oven. 5. Knife sharpener. 6. Slide warmer. And these are used for the various tissue processing procedures. And then microscope for the observation of the stained slides prepared from the tissues. The tissue specimen processing includes the following basic steps. 1. Fixing. When a tissue is removed from the body, it begins to decompose. To preserve the natural state as nearly as possible, the tissue is immediately placed into a solution called fixative, like formalin solution, and this process is called fixing. 2. Embedding. To provide necessary hardness to cut sections, infiltration of paraffin wax is carried out. This process is called embedding, which involves a removal of water by alcohol dehydration, b infiltration of xylene or chloroform as a solvent for paraffin wax, and c introduction of wax impregnation. 3. Microtomy. Thin sections, that means slices of the tissue, are cut by using an equipment called microtome. This is performed when the paraffin is solidified and the tissues are ready in the form of blocks. These thin sections are then prepared for staining. 4. Staining. The paraffin is removed from the section on the slide by drying and then by de-waxing. During de-waxing, the sections on the slide are treated first with xylene, and then the sections are rehydrated with ethyl alcohol in decreasing concentrations. The rehydrated sections are then stained by using appropriate staining methods. 5. Mounting. After staining, the sections on the slides are dehydrated by treating with ethyl alcohol in increasing concentrations and finally with xylene. By placing mounting medium such as Canara balsam and then By placing a cover slip on the mounting medium, the stem sections on the slide are said to be mounted. Well, these are the syllabus theory and practical topics of histopathology techniques. Now try to solve these MCQs and if necessary read and use 52 number chapter of this book. Thank you. opportunity to wish you all very happy and prosperous New Year and hope that we all will soon see end of Corona-19 pandemic phase. Kindly subscribe and share our videos on Praful Goenkar Educational Channel. Next time, I will bring you another online YouTube video. Till then, take care, enjoy every moment with happy heart and all necessary safety precautions. Goodbye.